original project was part of a track application back in around 2009, 2010. As a result of intermodal trains coming from the CSX mainline serving the Marion intermodal facility, there were about 10 to 15 trains per day. They would block the crossing, sometimes for 15 minutes, sometimes longer than that, and causing a real problem for people not only traveling along 309, but for emergency services, fire, and EMS, as well as for people simply trying to access the parks that were on either side of the crossing. At times, kids would simply get out of the car and climb through the trains to get to the baseball game. So that obviously was not a good situation.
The study looked at that congestion. We went to the public and evaluated alternatives.
One of the original alternatives was a realignment of 309 to simply avoid the crossing, to go around in behind the facility along a township road, basically, and then tie back in at 309 further to the east.
Initially, the public did not like the alternative. They thought we were skirting the problem. From the public's perspective, not only do we have a baseball for youth complex here on site, but we also have a senior center and a developmental disability school. So realigning would still leave the blocked crossing as a detrimental impact to their facilities. So we regrouped, we talked with the consultants, and confirmed that the grade separation was a better solution than the realignment.
The next challenge was funding. So what we did from the very beginning, we had an initial kickoff meeting, brought Brian into our office, and he was just part of our team. And so he established the initial goal for us to try and find cost savings for the project. So we were able to find solutions where we eliminated some retaining walls, eliminated the necessary relocation of some utilities that reduced that cost and brought this thing in to the budget that the ODOT had available.
We were continuously corresponding and addressing concerns. We actually ran this as more of a design build review format where we would give our reviewers 14 days, and then we would have comment resolution meetings to address the concerns on the spot and allow Mead and Hunt to continue developing the project in a timely manner.
Maintenance of traffic was a challenge. We wanted to keep traffic moving on 309. We were able to come up with a solution to we shifted the alignment slightly to the north, and were able to keep traffic moving on the existing road by using a temporary retaining wall during construction. That seemed to work out very well, and that saved a lot of money as well.
We had not a lot of drainage opportunities up here as far as an outfall was concerned. So the subsurface tiles were 100 years old. There was no good outlet to any stream close by. We petitioned the county to upgrade the tile and then take it over for long-term maintenance, which they got the easements, they did the work, we just utilized the outfall, and it saved us a lot of money and a lot of issues with right-of-way acquisition. And we were in jeopardy from the beginning of impacting a rectified gas line that actually had electric current through it. We really had to evaluate where we were going to uncover or fill over top of that gas line, and Mead and Hunt did a great job of helping us go from $1 million impact to a net zero impact to avoid having to relocate that line.
The Mead and Hunt team worked with ODOT, especially our environmental and real estate people, to come up with a solution that really worked to meet not just the transportation needs, but the local stakeholders' needs.
The senior center had a lot of unknowns when it came to transportation needs, emergency runs. Having this project complete, they now can look at the schedule and know when they're going to be able to make their runs and not have any obstructions, not have to take a detour.
So it was just communication and teamwork. You know, Brian set the initial target and goal for us. The clarity that he provided my team of what he would like to see us do really gave us the freedom to come up with some innovative ideas.
The constant communication, the partnering that we received with the department and Mead and Hunt was really what helped make this project happen with the schedule that we were constrained by.
So this project, as a railroad grade separation, is a lot more than that. It's a safety project, it's an economic development project, and it's also a quality of life project. The team really did a great job of turning this into something more than just a roadway project.
I think people should be very happy with the outcome of the project. Just driving through it today after, you know, it's been open for over a year or so now. It's working very well. The project looks very good. ODOT has made a very good improvement in this part of Marion County.